In this tutorial, we will try to explain step by step the color palette, color picker, and other color tools in MS Paint, what they do and their features. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. We open MS Paint and start with a clean blank canvas. But this time, we will also add a few creature images from nature to inspire us with colors to better understand the subject. If we briefly mention our color tools, the first one is the color picker tool. With our color picker tool, we can select a color on the canvas and use it for drawing. My next color tools are color 1 and 2, so color 1 is the foreground color that we can usually use with the drawing tools directly with the left mouse button, and represents the outline color for the shape section. The second color, background color, is used with the eraser tool or as a fill color for shapes. We have many ready-made colors in our color palette, and we can assign them to our first or second colors. We can also edit the color palette and add new colors. For this, we have the Edit Colors panel. We will talk about the Edit Colors panel in detail along with the other tools. First of all, as we mentioned, for a better understanding of the subject, we include a few images from the creatures in nature on our canvas to inspire us about colors. Notice that the creature images we added from nature to inspire us, such as birds and flowers, have many more colors than our ready-made color palette. When we hover over some of the colors in my color palette, we can see their names. Without wasting time, we open the Edit Colors panel to work with more colors. In the Basic Colors section of the Edit Colors panel, we can add more colors from our ready-made color palette or replace them with existing colors by selecting and confirming these or more. To show the first example, we choose three different colors in dark navy blue tones and include them in our color palette respectively, and apply them with a brush for a clearer understanding on the canvas. In the left section of the Edit Colors panel, the RGB, red, green, blue, color model, and its alternative HSL system, hue, saturation, and luminance, both methods represent a given color according to their three basic criteria. In the RGB color system, one of three different color values ranges from 0 to 255. For the basic brilliant green color, green has a value of 255, while red and blue have a value of 0 and have a different numerical value in the HSL system. For the basic bright green color, the hue value can be represented by the numbers 80, saturation to 140, and brightness 120. We can select a color from the color map in the left section of the Edit Colors panel, or create the color by entering its numeric values in the RGB or HSL sections. Once we have created the color, we can confirm it and add or change it in the custom color panel or directly in the empty space in our color palette. Now we create the basic colors we will use, add them to our palette, and then apply them to our canvas with a brush. By the way, the RGB color model, which we will talk about in more detail later, is an additive color model, and we quickly create a simple representation of it on our canvas. In the RGB color model system, red added to green produces yellow, green added to blue produces cyan, blue added to red produces magenta, and equally overlapping red, green, blue colors produce white. Next, we will talk about the CMYK color system and its differences with RGB. CMYK stands for four basic colors: cyan, magenta, yellow, black, or key in print language, and these colors are the primary colors. These colors overlap in the print with the TRAM small ink dots method and form other intermediate colors. In theory, the mixture of the three colors should form black, but in practice this is not the case. CMYK is a subtractive color model used in printing, and we will create a simple representation of this model on our canvas. We will sample the color transitions between cyan and yellow towards green with a marker pen. For this, we will use the color picker tool. With the color picker tool, we take a sample from each color intersection and intersect it again with the yellow color, thus obtaining many tones of green. We quickly apply the example we just made with an oil paint brush in more detail and over a wider range. In the second color blending and color gradient example, we use the color picker tool to select intermediate hues from red to yellow. We apply the watercolor brush step by step, and each time different hues of orange emerge. In the next example of color mixing and color gradient, we again use the color picker tool to select the intermediate tones, this time creating a color transition from red to blue. We follow the same steps as before to obtain different hues of the color purple with the natural pencil, which has a different style. When the color picker tool is left-clicked on a color on the canvas, it assigns the selected color to color one foreground color, but if right-clicked, it assigns the selected color to background color. As an example of using the color picker tool in another way, we will be inspired by the creatures in nature that we transfer to our canvas. We hover over the birds, insects, and plants and sample the color pixels we want and apply them one below the other with a brush on the right side of our canvas. Thus, we have come to the end of this training. If you haven't seen it, we recommend you watch the previous and subsequent tutorials in the series. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.